Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to discuss a new chapter, that is 14th chapter, kinetic theory. Kinetic theory explains the behavior of gases based on the idea that the gas consists of rapidly moving atoms or molecules. We know substances consist of molecules. Molecules consist of atoms. Atom consists of proton, neutron, and electrons. So here I am taking atom. So here it is a atom. Proton, neutrons are in nucleus. Nucleus is at the center of atom. So here it is nucleus. Proton, neutrons are existing nucleus. Electrons are revolving around the nucleus. So here it is an atom. The size of the atom is about 1 angstrom. So here 1 angstrom is equal to 10 to 4 of minus 8 meter or 10 to 4 of minus 10 centimeter. So here the size of an atom is about 1 angstrom. The distance between two atoms in a solid is about 2 angstroms. Distance between two atoms in a solid is about 2 angstroms. Distance between two atoms in a liquid is about 2 angstroms. Distance between two atoms in a gas is about 10 angstroms. Next one is mean free path. Here I am taking gas molecules. These are all gas molecules. Let us take one molecule. Here mean free path is nothing but the average distance a molecule can travel without collide. So here this average distance is nothing but mean free path. So here mean free path is nothing but the average distance a molecule can travel without collide is called mean free path. So this average distance is known as mean free path. In gases, mean free path is about 1000 angstroms. The average distance a molecule can travel without colliding is called the mean free path. So in gases, the mean free path is about 1000 angstroms. Next one is behavior of gases. Properties of gases are easier to understand than those of solids and liquids. This is mainly because in a gas, molecules are far from each other and their mutual interactions are negligible except when two molecules collide. Gases at low pressure and high temperature approximately satisfy a simple relation between pressure, volume and temperature is gases at low pressure and high temperature. Approximately satisfy a simple relation between pressure, volume and temperature is given by PV is equal to K into T. Let us take this is first equation. For a given sample of gas, K is constant. But varies with volume of the gas, that is K is proportional to volume. But we know volume is proportional to number of molecules of a gas. So here N is number of molecules of a gas. So from this two we can write K is proportional to N. So if we remove proportionality, here we have to take one proportionality constant. So that is K is equal to KB into N. So here KB is found same for all gases. So this constant is known as Boltzmann constant. So here KB is found same for all gases. So this constant is known as Boltzmann constant. So let us take this is equation 2. Substitute equation 2 in equation 1. We can get equation 2 in equation 1. We can get PV is equal KB N into T. So from this we can write PV by NT is equal to KB. So here KB is same for all gases, that is KB is a constant. So this constant is known as Boltzmann constant. So the value of Boltzmann constant KB is 1.38 into 10 to the 4 of minus 23. Here units are pressure into volume. So that is work done. So SI units for work done is joule. So that is joule by. So here N is number of molecules and T is temperature. So that is K. So here SI units for Boltzmann constant is joule for Kelvin. Here the value of Boltzmann constant KB is 1.38 into 10 to the 4 of minus 23 joule for Kelvin. From above equation we can write N is equal PV by KBT. So from this we can write N by V is equal P by KBT. So we know N by V, that is number of molecule per unit volume, is known as number density, that is small n is equal capital N by V. So that is number of molecules per unit volume. So that is equal, here N by V is equal P by KBT. Let us take this is third equation. Here KBT is Boltzmann constant. So this is same for all gases. So for different gases, if pressure and temperature is same, then N will be same. This is known as Avogadro hypothesis. From third equation, we can say the number of molecules per unit volume is same for all gases at a fixed temperature and pressure. Or equal volume of all gases under similar conditions of temperature and pressure contain equal number of molecules. Avogadro number. That is Na. The number of molecules in 22.4 liters of any gas is 6.02 into 10 to the 4 of 23. So this is known as Avogadro number. So that is Na is equal to how much it is? 6.02 into 10 to the 4 of 23. So here number of molecules in 22.4 liters of any gas is 6.02 × 10⁴. So this number of molecules is known as Avogadro number, that is Na is equal 6.02 × 10⁴. Mole. The mass of 22.4 liters of any gas is 1 gram/stp. Here STP means what? Standard temperature and pressure. Here standard temperature is 273 Kelvin and pressure is 1 atmosphere. This amount of substance is called a mole. Suppose we have taken mu moles of a gas. So its weight is small m and its molecular weight is M. So by definition of mole, so here 1 mole is equal to its molecular weight in grams at STP. So by definition of mole, we can write mass of 1 mole gas is equal to molecular weight. So that is capital M. For mass of mu mole of gas is how much? So that is small m is equal. So here mu into capital M by 1. Mu into capital M by 1. So from this we can write mu is equal small m by capital M. So here mu is equal, here small m is equal what? Actual mass by capital M is what? Molecular weight. By the definition of Avogadro number, number of molecules in 1 mole gas is 1 mole, that is equal to Avogadro number Na. So number of molecules in mu mole gas is how much? So that is N is equal here mu into Na by 1. Mu into Na by 1. So from this we can write mu is equal N by Na. Let us see different forms of perfect gas equation. we know that PV by NT is equal to KB. From this we can write PV is equal to NT into KB. So here we know mu is equal to N by NA. From this here N is equal to, we can write mu into NA. So here we can write N is equal to mu into NA. So here PV is equal to mu into NA into T into KB. So that is equal to, here PV is equal to, we can write mu is equal to here KB into NA into T. So here KB into NA is equal to, we know that is R. Here R is universal gas constant. So that is, so here we can write PV is equal to mu RT. So therefore here perfect gas equation is PV is equal to mu RT. We know N is equal to PV by KBT. So from this we can write N by V is equal to, so that is called P by KBT. So here N by V is nothing but number density, number of molecules for unit volume. So that is N is equal to P by KBT. So from this we can write, therefore pressure P is equal to KBNT. Third one is, we know PV is equal to mu RT. But we know mass density is equal to mass by volume. That is rho is equal to mass by volume. From this we can write V is equal to mass by density. And we know mu is equal to small m by capital M. So if you substitute these values in this equation, we can get P into, here volume is equal to mass by rho, that is equal, here mu is equal to small m by capital M into R T. So here small m cancel. So finally we can get, therefore P is equal to rho into R T by capital M. A gas that obeys PV is equal to mu R T exactly at all pressure and temperature is defined to be an ideal gas. That is, ideal gas obey PV is equal to mu RT equation. From this we can write PV by mu T is equal to R. We know R is universal gas constant. That is, here it is constant. So for an ideal gas, PV by mu T is constant. So here I am drawing a graph PV by mu T versus pressure. On y axis, here I am taking PV by mu T. On x axis, here I am taking pressure. For an ideal gas, PV by mu T is constant. So that is, the curve is like a straight line. So here for an ideal gas, the curve is straight line because here PV by mu T is constant. For real gas, the curve is like this. The curve is at T1 temperature. This curve is at T2 temperature. This curve is at T3 temperature. So these are all real gas curves. So from this graph, it is clear that real gas curves approaches ideal gas curves at low pressure and high temperature. So that is, here T1 is greater than T2 is greater than T3. So at high temperature, that is at high temperature, real gas curves approach ideal gas curve, because at low pressure or at high temperature, the molecules are far apart and molecular interactions are negligible. Without interaction, the gas behaves like an ideal gas. Next one is Boyle's law. The perfect gas equation is PV is equal to mu RT. So here mu is constant, R is constant. If I am taking at constant temperature, that is PV is equal, here mu is constant, R is constant, here I am taking temperature is also constant, that is these are all constant. So from this we can write PV is equal constant. So that is we can write P is inversely proportional to volume. So this is known as Boyle's law. So when temperature remains constant, pressure of a given mass of gas varies inversely with volume. So this is known as Boyle's law. Next one is Charles' law. The perfect gas equation is PV is equal to mu RT. So from this we can write V is equal to mu RT by P. Here mu is constant, R is constant. If I am taking P is constant, that is at pressure is constant. So we can write, so here mu, R and P are constant. So from this we can write V is proportional to T. So this is known as Charles' law. For a fixed pressure, the volume of a gas is directly proportional to its absolute temperature. This is known as Charles' law.